Hello and welcome to my Farsi class. Today we are going to learn two more letters of the Persian alphabet. The first letter which I'm going to teach you today is He, which has four different forms, and it's the equivalent of H in English, basically. This is the more common version of He. The second letter we're going to learn today is Ye, which is the equivalent of Y or I in English. And I'm going to show you how this letter appears in different words and how you're supposed to read it. So let's get started. Let's focus on the first one, He. As I said, this is the more common version of He. You have learned another version of He in one of my earlier alphabet videos, but this one that we're learning today is more common. Look at this word, Har. Here, the letter He has appeared at the beginning of the word. This word means every or each. Har. So when H or He appears at the beginning, in this case, this is the particular form of it that we use. The second word, the second example is Ra, which means path or way. And here the letter He has appeared at the end of the word and it is not connected to the previous letter, Ra. So here we're using this particular version. Looks like a drop. And we use it when the letter He again appears at the end of a word and is not connected to the previous letter. In the third example, we have the word Bahar, which means spring, you know, spring, summer, fall, winter, spring. And here you can see the letter He has appeared in the middle of the word. So it's not the first, it's not the last. It's somewhere in the middle of the word, Bahar. And this is why it kind of looks like this particular, you know, like looks like number 8 in English, this particular format. We also have another form for this version of He. So it's possible that, you know, you will see both of them depending on the particular handwriting of people. Some people prefer the first version, others prefer the second version. Now, in the fourth example, we have the word Khane, and here we have the letter He appearing at the end of a word, but this time it is connected to the previous letter, and this is why it looks different from the He that you saw, for example, in Ra, okay? Now, something that's quite interesting, this version of He can also be written differently. So, there are two versions again, you know, of He when it appears at the end of a word. Now, interestingly enough, Khane, in this word, the H is not really pronounced. It's just written, but it's mute. So we have a kind of like a mute He at the end of a word. Now, let's have a look at the second letter that we are going to learn today. So, the second letter for today is the letter Ye, which, as I explained, is the equivalent of Y or I in English. Depends on, you know, the type of word that we're going to use this letter in. You're going to see it in a second. Okay, so this letter Ye, in fact, is also written in two different forms depending on where in a word it's going to appear. So, for example, if we have a word which actually starts with the letter Ye, the way it's going to look like is going to be different from a word where Ye comes at the end. So, for example, here Ye is at the end of the word. The word is Razi. So here the sound is E in this particular case. And basically it means satisfied or content. The letter Ye is at the end of a word here. And in the second example, the letter Ye is at the beginning. So we have the word Yas, which means lilac, you know, the flower. And here, because Ye has appeared at the beginning of the word, you see that it's used in this particular format. Now, if Ye is in the middle of the word also, we will use the same form. So, which is the one with two dots under. So here we have in, the word in, which literally means this in Farsi. Okay, so quickly, if Ye is at the end, you can see in the first version how it looks like, and if it's at the beginning or in the middle, it's a version with two dots under, right? This is another example. For example, we have the word tiq, and here again you see the letter ye or e. In fact, in this case, the sound is e in the middle. So tiq means thorn or razor, and as you can see, it's the version of ye which has two dots under. So probably you will see this version of ye much more often because there are more words which start or you know, kind of will have this letter in the middle rather than words which will end with ye. Okay, friends, guess what? We just completed the whole Persian alphabet. So now officially, yay, which in Farsi is hurrah, and congratulations on having learned the complete, you know, series of Persian alphabet, and now you can basically, you know, understand how every word sounds. If you see it written in Persian script, you can read and write, and well, you can in fact start having a look at newspapers or start reading books, or you can look up words in dictionaries. So I'm very happy for you. Thank you so much for staying with me throughout this series. It was a pleasure. And ta-bad, now you can read it, ta-bad, which means till later. Khodafez, ciao, bye-bye.